Good morning, students. So in this video, we will discuss with the diseases which are caused by protozoans. So here, protozoans are one type of organisms, disease-causative organisms, which enters by the different modes of transmission. So it may be by the bite of mosquitoes or by the contaminated food and water. So in this protozoan diseases, so first we will discuss with the disease called malaria. So among the protozoans diseases, the diseases which are caused by the protozoans, this malaria is most dangerous and pandemic disease, and throughout worldwide, so this malaria is spreading all over the, from patients to patients in a rapid rate. And here, if you will see that malaria, and this malaria is caused by a protozoan organism which is known as Plasmodium vivax. Plasmodium vivax. And that term malaria was derived from Italian language word, from the word which is from Italian language, which means, so that means malaria means bad air. Bad air. Because why it is known as malaria means, in those days, in the earlier days, the people thought that the malaria is mainly caused by this bad air. And this mala means, in Italian language, mala means bad. Mala means bad. And aria means air. Aria means air. So by combining these two words from the Italian language, this term was derived, malaria, which means bad air. Because in those days, the people thought that the malaria is mainly caused by this bad air. And later, the Charles Laveran, another scientist, Charles Laveran, discovered that the parasite, that Plasmodium vivax, so Plasmodium vivax, he was found this parasite in the blood of mosquito. So in the mosquito, in mosquito, he was found this Plasmodium vivax. So in the saliva of, sorry, not blood, in the saliva of mosquito. And later, the Sir Ronald Ross, so he was a military doctor, army doctor, and who was working for Indian Army. And he was, when he was working in Secunderabad, the city where it is now in Telangana state, Secunderabad, so where he was working, and he found that the some granule-like structures are gametocytes in the crop of the mosquito. In the digestive system of the mosquito, he found such gametocytes of Plasmodium vivax. So he found some structures on the crop. So crop is one part of digestive system in the mosquito. So on the wall of this crop, there are so many granule-like structures of this mosquito was present, sorry, of the Plasmodium vivax. And this was discovered by Sir Ronald Ross on 28th of August. He was found on that day. And for that work, he has given the Nobel Prize. Nobel Prize for his work in 1902. And on the every year of 20th August of every year, so it was celebrated as World Malaria Day. World Malaria Day or World Mosquito Day. World Mosquito Day. It is 20th of August. Of every year, it is celebrated as World Malaria Day or World Mosquito Day. And this is the brief history of the malaria disease. And when we see that the Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium vivax, so among the protozoan parasites, this Plasmodium vivax is the most common and dangerous parasite which causes this dangerous disease, so that is malaria. And there are four different types of Plasmodium species are there which causes different types of malaria. And this Plasmodium is a protozoan, which belongs to the protozoa, and it is a diagenetic, and it is intracellular parasite. So diagenetic parasite means, so already we discussed that what is diagenetic organism means. It completes its life cycle in two different hosts. In case of Plasmodium, the two hosts are, the primary host is mosquito and secondary host is man. So it is man and mosquito, or mosquito we can write first, primary host, and man is a secondary host. And another host is also the reservoir host, where there is no development takes place. And intracellular, so in case of human beings, this parasite lives in liver cells and RBC. So that's why intracellular, within the cells the parasite lives. So here in case of human beings, it is intracellular. That means in the liver cells as well as in the RBCs, the parasite lives. And in mosquito, it is extracellular in mosquito. Because on the wall of the crop, so on the cell membrane or on the wall of the crop, this parasite lives. So that's why it is extracellular in mosquito and intracellular parasite in human beings. And when we see that the life cycle, so as it is a diagenetic parasite, and it completes its life cycle in two different hosts, so like mosquito and man, and the life cycle is also different in man and mosquito. In mosquitoes, its life cycle takes place by sexual reproduction. And in man, its development takes place through asexual reproduction. And now we will see the different events which are takes place in man as well as in mosquito, how this parasite undergo the development in man and in mosquito. So first we will see that the life cycle in man. Life cycle of Plasmodium in man. and this phase is known as the human phase. The human phase. How this parasite enters into the human beings means by the bite of the mosquito. So if the mosquito, if it contains the some stages of the Plasmodium vivax, and that stage at which the Plasmodium enters into the human beings is sporozoite stage. At this stage, the parasite enters into the human beings. So from mosquito to the man, human beings, it enters at the stage of sporozoite. Very, very important life cycle in point of view competitive and as well as per PU. And sporozoite stage, these sporozoites enters into the human beings by the bite of female Anopheles mosquito. Now we will see how the life cycle, how the development of these sporozoites takes place. And before going to that stages discussion, we will first see what is the structure of sporozoite. So sporozoite structure, ultra structure of sporozoites. It is in sickle shaped structure. And here in the middle of this cell, it is swollen, and towards the ends, both the ends is narrower. It is pointed. Pointed ends, and other cell organelles also present like nucleus, Golgi complex, mitochondria, cytoplasm, endoplasmic reticulum, these all present in this sporozoite. So the mitochondria also present, nucleus and all other cell organelles like Golgi complex, these all present. And at the anterior end, there is a cup-like structure called apical cup is also present. Apical cup, into which the secretory organelles are woven into this apical cup. And this is known as sporozoite. At this sporozoite stage, the Plasmodium enters into the human beings. And this structure was given by the scientist known as Gunham. So he was given the ultra structure of the sporozoite. So the sporozoite is a sickle shaped structure. And it has the cell organelles like cytoplasm and endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi complex, mitochondria, nucleus. These cell organelles are present, and the cytoplasm shows the waving movements. So the waves of cytoplasm are appeared in the sporozoite stage. And this cytoplasm also contains some skeletal structures, and these skeletal structures function was unknown. There is no clarity about the function of these skeletal structures which are present in the cytoplasm of the sporozoite. And now we will see the development process in human beings. When the mosquito bites along with its saliva, these sporozoites enters into the human blood. Along with its mosquito saliva, and nearly 2000 spores are released into the human's blood by a single bite of the mosquito, female Anopheles mosquito. The 2000 sporozoites will be released into the blood, and from there it starts the asexual reproduction, and from the blood they reaches liver cells. And in human beings, it development takes place by asexual reproduction. That's why it is known as cyzygony. And these sporozoites from the blood, they reaches to the liver cells. In liver cells as well as in RBC, it undergoes the asexual reproduction. So in the liver cells, the development is known as hepatic cyzygony. Hepatic cyzygony. This means the asexual reproduction takes place in liver cells. That process is known as hepatic cyzygony. And if the asexual reproduction takes place in RBC, that is erythrocytes, it is known as erythrocytic cyzygony. And first we will see in the liver cells what development takes place. From the blood it reaches to the liver cells, and here it undergoes two different events. So one is pre-erythrocytic cycle and exo-erythrocytic cycle. Means pre-erythrocytic cycle means before reaching to the RBC, in the liver cells, what is the development takes place? That is under pre-erythrocytic cycle. And exo-erythrocytic cycle, outside the RBC, what is the development takes place? So that is exo-erythrocytic cycle. And first of all, before entering into these two stages, two cycles, what are the events takes place in the liver cells? So here, in the hepatic cyzygony, what happens exactly means these sporozoites, which are in sickle shape, this is the sickle shaped cell, it feeds on the contents of liver cell. What are the contents present in the liver cell? That are fed by the sporozoites. And as a result of that, this sporozoites, which is in sickle shape, becomes spherical shape. So that is the shape of the cell becomes spherical shape. And here this stage is now called tropozoite stage. And here this continues the feeding of the liver cell contents, like cell organelles of the liver cells, and these now becomes grow in size, they become larger in size, and the cytoplasm of these cells becomes periphery. It most periphery. And now it appears as a finger ring, ring-like structure. It appears as a ring-like structure. And that's why this stage is known as signet ring stage. Signet ring stage. And this structure now, it is known as cryptozoids. It is known as cryptozoids. Or first generation merozoids. Or first generation merozoids. And these are the stages which are takes place in the liver cell. And now these first generation merozoids have two options. They are having two options. So what are the two options means? The first option is they enter into fresh liver cell. They can enter into fresh liver cells. Or they enter into the bloodstream and they reaches RBC. These are the two options. So here, if they enter into the fresh liver cell, they continue the exoerythrocytic cycle. Exoerythrocytic cycle. If they enter into the RBC, they continues erythrocytic cycle. Erythrocytic cycle. See, first we will see if they enter into the fresh liver cells, they continue exoerythrocytic cycle. So that is exoerythrocytic cycle. In this, the first generation merozoids, again they see now the fresh liver cells are present and the cell contents or cell organelles now feeded by these merozoids. And as a result of this, the merozoids, the first generation merozoids, they becomes like a rose petals. They arranged in this manner. That's why this stage is called rosette stage. And here, these become first generation merozoids are continue to divide. The nucleus is continuous mitotically divides and they form second generation merozoids, or these are also known as megacryptozoids. So here, these megacryptozoids are of two types again. There are two types. Smaller megacryptozoids are known as micro megacryptozoids. And larger ones are known as macro megacryptozoids. Macro megacryptozoids. And now these two, micro megacryptozoids and macro megacryptozoids, among these two, the smaller micro megacryptozoids, they enters into again the liver cell and continuous exoerythrocycles and larger macromegacryptozoids then enters into the RBC. So further development will take place in other within the erythrocytes, that is in RBCs. So this is exoerythrocytic cycle. Now if we will see that the erythrocytic cycle which is takes place in RBC, here the macro mega cryptozoids, these cells or these parasites at this phase enters into the fresh RBC, and here they feeds on the contents of RBC. As a result of that, they increase its size. See, now it is present in the RBC, these cryptozoids, and they feeds on the feeds on the RBC contents. As a result of that, these increases their size. As a result of this, the entire RBC cells also become double. It doubles in size. So the size also increases, and this condition is known as hypertrophy. Hypertrophy means the RBC cell becomes double in its size. Why? The cryptozoids or mega cryptozoids, they are increasing in size rapidly. As a result of that, automatically the RBC size also increases. Then continuously the cell divisions takes place in the RBC, and the number of mega cryptozoids increases, and as a result of that, the RBC number gradually decreases. And now these macro mega cryptozoids, they attack the new RBC which are present in spleen and bone marrow. And these stages actually present in the blood, we come to know that the presence of parasites by the diagnosis process, and this is the symptomatic stage. So for the symptomatic stage, it is nearly 10 to 14 days. Incubation period for this is 10 to 14 days. The entire process completes in 10 to 14 days. So here, and another one is the pre-patent period. What is pre-patent period means? So later we will discuss that pre-patent. Now if we will see that, if the mega cryptozoids, when they reaches the blood, and now they forms the gametocytes. Two types of gametocytes are formed, not gametes, because gamete formation takes place in the mosquito. Only gametocytes are formed, and these gametocytes are transferred from human beings to the mosquito. And there are two types of gametocytes are formed from these mega cryptozoids, and these are known as mega gametocytes or female gametocytes. These are also known as female gametocytes, and the second one is microgametocytes or male gametocytes. these two types of gametes enters into the mosquito when the mosquito bites a infected person. And now, what is pre-patent period? There are two times the pre-patent period has occurred in the human beings. One is pre-patent period of pre-erythrocytic cycle. Pre-erythrocytic cycle, and it is the time period between the first entry of parasite into the blood at the stage of sporozoids, and second entry of parasite into blood in the form of cryptozoids. This is known as pre-patent period of pre-erythrocytic cycle. And pre-patent period of exo-erythrocytic cycle means the period between first entry of parasites into the blood as sporozoids and the second entry of the parasite into the blood at the stage of or as megacryptozoids and gametocytes. And these gametocytes from the blood to the mosquito, they are transferred when the mosquito bites an infected person. And this is the life cycle of Plasmodium in man, which completes, or the symptoms appears at the time period of 10 to 14 days. That means the incubation period is 10 to 14 days. And in the next class, we will discuss with the life cycle of Plasmodium in mosquito. That is sexual reproduction of Plasmodium.